Well, hello there, people. I got this idea, or crazy idea, or thought that let's see if we can live open source only on Windows. And what do I mean by that? Well, let's lay out some things that I can only talk for myself, but things that I normally would be using my computer for, and then see if there is free and open source alternatives for that on the Windows, meaning that maybe the operating system is not free and open source, but the programs I use is. And to me, that's a big step. That's, you know, great. That's amazing, because you're using and promoting open source software, free and open source software. You're just not using Linux. So let's go into it. So I want to do office work, and I'm dyslexic, so there will be a shit ton of spelling mistakes. Office, internet, graphic work, video editing, coding, gaming, media playback. I think that's it. Let's keep it with that. So I'm not going to download and install all of them. I'm going to open up a non-free and open source browser, aka Google Chrome. And then we are just, you know, searching free and open source Office Suite, and then we can see what options we have out there. But let's see what we can find out here. So if I do here, then open source Office Suites. We have LibreOffice, 21 best free Office Suites. Oh, that's not open source. Well, OpenOffice and LibreOffice, all of them here. But at least we found two. And there are, we also have Abbey Words and stuff like that, you know. So that's a massive yes. Like, massive yes. Internet browsing. And we quite have, like, we have Firefox, Chromium, Brave. Well, that's also a massive yes. Graphic work. Let's just do graphic editors. We have Game, Blender, DigiCam. We also have Quitter. If you go in here, we have Inkscape. We do have some options, but it's not like massive. Like, we don't have like almost unlimited options for graphic work. So I would just put in a yes there. Like, not it, there's not like a massive amount of options, but you can definitely get your day-to-day work functioning with graphic editors and design software and stuff like that. Open source video editing software. Oh, they already have them here. So we have Shortcut, OpenShot, Blender, Cadian Live, Flowblade, Avidmux, Vidcorder, Lives, Neutron. There's a few. I can't remember. There's a few that they are missing here. But yeah, we have like, not massive, but I would say okay. So yes, we can do it. Also, I really botched this up here. So let's do yes. Then we have coding. Atom, Azure, Atom. I think that's being discontinued. Bitbucket, Dreamweaver, Eclipse, Cherry, Lynx, NetBeans, Node.js, Zen Studios. I'm talking from experience here. There's a lot of open source IDEs. Let's try open source IDE. So yeah, I would definitely give that a massive yes. Open source games. That's one that I'm a little bit. Oh, I used to play this a lot. Flight Gear, Super Talks, Free Civ is also one I used to play. So there is a, I would not say a lot of open source games. Super Talks is great. I would put this in here as a somewhat yes. Media players. And here we have VLC, SM Player, MPV, Kodi, Audacious Mio. There is a shit ton of media players that's open source for Windows. So already here we can go in and we can say massive yes. Again, this is a little bit of an exercise for you guys and girls and me also. If I was like, Windows cannot, or Linux cannot do everything I want it to do. It could be hardware problem. It could be I just need Windows for work. But what I do, the programs I'm going to use in my spare time or that I use every day, can I do what I use my computer for and only using open source software if I happen to need Windows for work or for, you know, like, there are places or workplaces where they require you to have Windows so you can log on to their Wi-Fi or their internet because they don't like the Linux. I can go into why that is. It's not complicated, but it'll take longer next time. If I'm forced to use Windows for some reason or another, like there's one program that I need Windows for, two programs I need Windows for work or stuff like that, but can I do what I do on a daily basis under Windows with open source software? And the answer is yes. Some you have a lot of options, some you a little bit, and in other places it's like, yes, you have options, but you're losing either functionality or features. And to me, that's a really good compromise. Like, this is one step closer to Linux. You can live in a world where you are using Windows, but also promoting open source software. And I think we need to be more open to that notion. Instead of yelling and screaming at people that need Windows, then be like, okay, why not use this video, or sorry, this office suite instead of that office suite? It will maybe be better for you, help you out. It's cheaper, it has the same features. You know, you can do the same thing, but you don't have to pay for it and all these kind of things. That's a good compromise. It's not all or nothing, people. We are not living in a black and white world. So please remember that when you're going crazy in the comment section and yelling and screaming at me, but, oh, using Windows. Yeah, but there could be Windows users out there using more open source software than you're doing under Linux. Just saying. So yeah, a fun little exercise. See you all later. Bye-bye.